ready to run. Gate Spring Racing, gee, Janora got out like a slingshot, hit the front within about 50 metres over Excerpt, guarded away very quickly, Pans Down's up there, so's Pinball Player driving up towards the inside as they'd settle properly, and then deeper out, blazing away, two lengths further back, Sublime Mind Detector, further back behind then came Waterhorse and tailed off a long last is Regardless. Well, the pace is on in earnest as they head past the 550, the flying filly Janora just in front with Excerpt going up to Eyeball. Ball her, guarded, stranded, three deep outside of those, a length and a half to Pinball Player being followed by Pans Down. Excerpts run off the track and taken guarded with it there. They're almost here against the outside rail. Janora's the leader, about a length and a half as Pike makes his move with the favourite Pans Down. Pans Down, Janora brushing leather at the 150. They've come away with 100 left to go. He now shakes up Pans Down and Pans Down extends, comes away. The debutante Pans Down beat Janora, flying up on the rails regardless. Regardless in a photo with Pinball Player for third, then blazing away. Next home, Mind Detector. They were followed by Excerpt, who hung like a wisdom tooth coming around the turn and took guarded right there with it to the Windan Bridge. They were followed further back by Sublime and with it as well as Waterhorse. Pans Down is the winner ridden by William Pike, one that he can tick off now as he heads towards his own Australian record. He chalks up another there, an eventful run to the corner, though, with Excerpt hanging right off and taking guarded with it. And this left Pike sitting there, smoking the pipe, right on the back of the flying filly Janora. And over the last 150, it was all Pans Down. It was a pants job here in the first event by Panzer Division from Moon Rush, trained by Cy Miller, ridden by William Pike for Madame's Griffith Sangelli, the Zito brothers, from out there at J&M Smash, also Mrs. R. Fitzgerald, a B. Lyon, Ms. M. Stevenson, B. Jokic, and Mrs. L. Sinclair, B. Sinclair, J. Brennan, and Mrs. E. P. Brennan, and it wins most impressively. Number one, Janora is second by Safeguard from Com C for Laura Jordan, Janine Chalwell, trained by Paul Jordan, ridden by Ryan Hill. And number nine, Regardless, got the nod for third, coming from the back last against the rail by Safeguard from Hard to Trade for D and Mrs. D.M. Fisher, Mrs. A and G.J. Fisher, trained by Adam Ferry and ridden by Kira Yule. Fourth, number four, Pinball Player. After the running of the first, it's 7.19.4. Margins 2¾ by two lengths and the time 59.06. 34.27, the last 600 there. Well, it was a very impressive win, but I think we need to probably consider the bad luck afforded to Guarded, which did finish back, but got run right off on the home corner. It was too good for them. Pans Down, no doubt. Janora again, giving 110% the filly, and Regardless, a nice enough debut, cutting the corner up against the cutaway. The next event, the Amelia Park Plate, again over 1,000 metres, a field of 11, and no changes there. Let's go downstairs now. We'll catch up with Brittany. A $60,000 Inglis Classic Sale purchase and a half to $1 million stakes earner here and in Hong Kong, a horse called Country Star. This horse might have a future.
Do Darren, well shopped for $60,000, and Pans Down makes it a perfect start to his racing career. Simon Miller celebrates a birthday today, and Simon, you can't ask for a much better present than a winner to start the day.
Yeah, it's very true. Thanks, Britt. Just got to give a big plug to Chris Russell from William Inglis, Rusty. Him and I pound the pavement and hit the sales every year, and we trim it up, and every year we play a party in our whole stable and what we buy, and I couldn't get to Classic Sale, first one in years. For the right reasons, of course. Olivia was being born on the day of the sale, so I would have got gelded if I had gone there. So Rusty pounded the pavement and said, this is the one I need to buy. So backed him in, and obviously he's a good judge. And this, I think he was more nervous than me coming to the races today. He was sweating on it.
He would have been too. He's obviously a wonderful judge, as you mentioned. Behind the scenes, what had the show shown you?
Oh, he's always got the ability. He's just a menace. To be honest, you'll see a much better horse over 1,200 than 1,000, but my concern going to 1,200 today was it'd give him an extra 200 metres to do things wrong. And Willie probably could have led in hindsight, but I just said don't lead, because you'd probably pull up or float or do something silly. But he's got a V8 engine with my brain.
God help him. For a horse that is immature, as you described, to see him where he was in the run, it can be hard for them to be cluttered in amongst horses. Were you impressed with what he was able to do early in the piece?
I was. I was more impressed. Willie checked him a couple of times to rein him back in, and you just knew how good he was going, and he wanted to get going. He had nowhere to go, so...
Had nowhere to go until the seas just parted on the corner. Could you believe the luck?
Yeah, I know. It was luck. And when the seas parted, I knew he was going to let rip because he's just a talent. So that'll pay for my plumbing bills that he ruined. He just ruins everything at the stables. He picks things up, breaks things and sets everyone up. He dug a hole to China the other day and ripped out some pipe, which you didn't even know was down the bottom. And he had a water feature going off in his box. So we had to get the plumber in. So this will pay for it.
Well, you don't mind when they win. Well done.
And just quick curate. Obviously, sad news about Harvey Crossman, and also a good friend of mine in Melbourne, Rob Gaylard, and Casey Bruce, just thinking of you. And that wins for both of them.
Really nicely said. Well done, Simon.
Thanks, Britt.
Simon Miller, after the victory of Pans Down, and we've obviously lost a couple greats in the racing industry this week, and of course that news about Harvey coming through this morning, which has devastated the whole community, of course. And William Pike now chatting with Simon Miller. After the victory of Pans Down, he just needs one to equal his own record and two to surpass his own Australian riding record in a season.